Yeah, what's up? It's your boy, Jimmy.
Seems like these boxing videos get a fuck ton of views, so I decided to talk about boxing for today.
Really big I want to talk about is nerves before sparring. Like, any boxer will tell you.
Yeah, I don't feel fear, I don't feel nerves, I don't feel anything before sparring. Just the excitement. They're usually lying to you, because for the most part, the nerves before boxing is going to be insane. Oftentimes unbearable. Like right now, I got my contacts in, I got all my equipment, I got everything, I have no excuse, zero excuses. But like even then, like the nerves are unbearable. Like there's thoughts overflowing my mind, I'm trying to slow down in order for the video to make sense. And thoughts are like, oh, what if I get whooped? What if I get destroyed? What if I get knocked down again? What if my stamina runs out? What if like my jab doesn't work properly? Like there's so many, there's 100 things going on in my head. But like the problem is like I know I'm a good boxer, I know I got hands, I know I got good technique, but I still feel this way. I can fight, bro, but I still feel this way. And like my opponents usually aren't the best of the best, because it's not like the amateur and professional sparring day. It's Thursday, which is like a normal people sparring day. Yeah, it's just overwhelming, bro. It's like I missed training yesterday, so I couldn't get like a proper feel of the gym before for training. I couldn't get a feel of the ring. I couldn't get a feel of the shadow box in there. Bro, it's crazy, man.
It's unbearable. It's unbearable.
Where's the bus coming? 5 minutes. And I also like, I'm super late for my standard. Usually like, I go there at 6 p.m. I just click the button. I usually end up there at 6 p.m. But this time around, I'm like, it's 6:10 and I just left my house. And it starts 6:45, so I'm not late. But for my own standards, I am late, because I usually try to come early so I can get 3 hours of training in. But like my dumbass just avoided training like a pussy. And yeah, took great balls to even get out of my house. I needed to piss the entire time. And I just can't help with it. And I usually try to go there and sweat it out, because you either sweat or you pee, right? It's too much. Like, I have so much respect for people that get into the ring. I have so much respect for people that fight. There's so many nerves involved. There's so much like, involved. There's so much risk. So much adversity involved. And usually it's in your own mind, but like, still, those demons in your mind are still real. Jesus Christ. Like, oh, man, professional fighters, they have like 50-0 records. He's a hell of a fighter. Like, oh, the amount of trauma you just have to accept and use as a tool to mold yourself is insane. Like, I'm just sparring. I'm not gonna die. I'll probably work my jab, work to the body. If he goes a bit hard, I go a bit hard too. I'm not afraid to say, yeah, chill, way up. I got contacts in. You might punch my contacts out. You might cut my eye. At least like a permanent injury. I don't mind shredding my ego completely and utterly, like for the sake of, how do I say this? For the sake of being safe in my sparring. But motherfucker, man, it's just heart pounding. And I got my headphones here. I can try to listen as much Sigma Crisis as I can. Like, God, bro. You know, there's like 1,000 people watching. What do you guys think? Oh man. What do you think? You guys are the experts. My God. Catch you next video.
I'm good. You dropped his mouth on the floor.
No cards, punches. Understand about stop talking. I don't want to hear you talking. Jimmy, don't just stand in front of it, in and out, move to the left, move to the right. Yeah? Well, we'll be using both of them soon, but yeah, at the moment. Where's the faints, Jimmy? Where's the faints? That's it. Can't stop talking that boy, can you? Move your feet, Jimmy. You're standing still. You're just standing still, right in front of him. Move your feet, in and out, out and in. And the body. Head, then body. Head, then body. Stop. Steady.
The business is here.
Steady. Keep your head down and your hands up. Hold ya. Keep your
keep your hands up. You're doing the exact opposite. Drops up, Jimmy.
Overall, I think it was a successful spar. I could have done a lot better. I know my technique, my sense of my body was exposed. I didn't parry properly to it. A lot of things I need to go back to the drawing board and study on it. I think tomorrow I'll study on it. I had nerves, as you can tell. Really big nerves, really big anxiousness, really big thoughts. And, you know, everything's coming at me like a train. But I still went and sparred anyway. And I wasn't afraid to tell my opponent, hey, go lie on me, considering he's 120 kilograms. Put in American terms, he's 50 kg heavier than me, or 110 pounds heavier than me. So I'm like, yeah, go fucking lie on me, what the fuck? I'm more than glad to say that. I'm more than glad to say it to anyone. Even I know. To a person, opponent who's, I know, is less skilled than me, it's always nice to have good clean boxing, and always nice to practice good clean technique before, how do I say this, before, like, just getting into a spar, just going hard immediately, getting brain damage, that's the best thing I've done. Yeah, it took real discipline to get out of my house that time, it took real discipline to, you know, not be a bitch. To put that in layman's terms, it was very, very difficult. But I still did it anyway. And that's the whole point of this video. The whole point is, yes, I'm scared. Yes, everything's coming at me at once. Yes, I feel nerves. I feel anger. I feel excitement. I feel fear. Anger, excitement, fear, anxiety. From my heart pulsating. I feel as if there's a giant pressure underneath my heart. I feel like my lungs are crushing in, everything under the sun, all the emotions, because your body is putting more adrenaline in your system, in your blood, and that's triggering a fight or flight response. And my response is flight, or fawn, or flee, or freeze. It's not fight. That fight response in the fight or flight response spectrum, like, it's not there. I was born a pussy. But I chose to be a man.
And yeah, get in the ring and do the man dance. That's it. That's all the thing. I struggled with against my second opponent. It was taller than me, weighed heavier than me, but honestly, like, I should not struggle on him. I know it's just I try to remember back to spar. It was different. It's a guy who was way much more. He was only a bit taller than me. I felt like I managed him more, but yeah, he was going loud on me, so yeah, that was fine. He literally just tapped me and it hurt. I remember telling him that shit. It's fucking crazy. 50 kg is fucking crazy, bro. I can feel that. I can feel every single kilogram difference that we had. Yeah, it's crazy looking back. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys get enough balls to spar as well. Catch you guys in the next video. Peace. Leave me up with that mediocre.